We've all heard it. 1 inch of fish per gallon. Sounds simple, right? Way too simple. Today, I'll give you 7 reasons why this old school rule is totally wrong and how it can wreck your tank if you believe it. If you want real fish keeping advice without the myths, hit subscribe and let's dive in. Number 7. Fish grow like crazy. That tiny 1-inch Oscar at the store? Yeah, it turns into a 12-inch tank buster. This rule ignores growth completely. Your fish don't stay fun-sized forever. Number 6. Body shape matters. A 1-inch neon tetra isn't the same as a 1-inch goldfish. Some fish are slim, some are chunky. And let's be real, 1 inch of guppy poop is not equal to 1 inch of goldfish poop. Number 5, behavior and territory. Fish aren't little robots that just float around politely. They chase, they fight, they claim spots. 1 inch per gallon doesn't care if your tank is a peaceful school or a battlefield. Number 4, filtration and flow. A tank with a weak filter, even a few fish is risky. A smaller tank with a powerful filter handles way more. It's not gallons of water, it's how much waste your system can actually process. Number 3, science speaks, mass beats length. Here's where the math crushes this myth. Studies show fish mass increases with length cubed, not evenly. So 10 1-inch fish is not equal to 1 10-inch fish. That big guy produces way more waste than the math suggests. Length-based rules, scientifically doomed. Number 2, tank shape and oxygen. A tall, skinny tank has fewer surface inches for gas exchange. A wide tank of the same gallons gives your fish room to breathe. It's tank footprint, not the number on the box. Number 1, true stocking equals balance. Stocking isn't about lazy formulas. It's about the balance. Filtration, tank size, species behavior, and water changes. That's how you keep fish alive long term. So toss the 1-inch rule in the trash. Bonus, ecosystem. So here's the smarter path. Stop counting inches. Start building an ecosystem. Think in layers. A peaceful school for the middle, a cleanup crew at the bottom, maybe a calm centerpiece, fish up top. I've seen tanks crammed full because someone followed the inch rule. Total chaos, stressed fish everywhere. And I've seen tanks with fewer but well-matched fish, and they looked like an underwater neighborhood. That's the difference. Don't stock by math, stock by harmony. What about you? Ever tried the inch rule and ended up with a crowded tank? Or maybe learned the hard way that compatibility matters more than gallons? Share your story in the comments. I bet other fish keepers can relate. And if this myth busting saved you some stress, hit like and subscribe. See you next time.